This video marks 2,000 subs, so thanks very much for all that. I've looked at this CRT. This is an educational cathode ray tube. I've looked at this before. It's used for electrostatic and electromagnetic deflection. But it's a particular setup that I've been made aware of by Anthony Francis Jones' physics site. So I'll put a link to his channel below. And it's rather an interesting demonstration, so I thought it's worth doing again. We're going to operate the tube more or less to the limits of its designed voltages, just so we can get this electron beam to behave in an interesting way. We're going to try and basically slow it down, well, accelerate it with our first anode and then slow it down, see what happens. Okay, I've connected this up. I've basically got two separate high voltage supplies. I've got to apply a voltage across these two plates here. Our limit for that would be about 5 kV. And we also have the accelerating anode voltage here, which should be limited to about 4 kV. And our heater filaments at the back here are no more than 7.5 volts maximum. So we'll try and take the heater first up to about, try it at 6 volts. There's quite a lot of light here, so we might not see that yet. And then I shall bring up the anode voltage, and we should see a line. Now, there's too much light here, so I'm going to turn the lights down. As you see, with the lighting down, we now have a straight through electron beam travelling across the fluorescent plate at the back there. If we now apply a voltage to the plates, we can deflect the beam so that it's travelling up. So that's with the electrostatic deflection. I'll now apply a current to the coil here. And as we bring up the current, we can negate the effect from deflection from the positive plate. However, this is where it gets a bit more interesting, because if I now keep increasing the current in the coil, we can bring the beam down so that it's trying to hit the negative plate, which it won't do, and then the electrons are slowing down and then come back up off the plate. I think the really fascinating thing is the fact that we are firing out an electron beam here accelerated by this anode, and this is then being forced down onto this plate by the magnetic field. That slows this beam right down to the point where the magnetic field no longer has an influence on it, and the only thing that's influencing the electrons are the positive and negative plates here, that therefore trying to then be re-accelerated up to the positive plate by that field. The minute it starts to move, it's then starting to feel the force from the magnetic field and is forced back down onto the negative plate again. It's a really interesting experiment. I've never seen that done on anything else.